Hey everyone, it's Justine from Gluten Free Aussie Vegan. Today I'm going to make a gluten free vegan cheese sauce. Let's get started. So first up, you'll need to chop up the potatoes. Yeah, you only need to do them roughly because they're going to get blended later. And then just add some hot water to that and put them to the boil and cook them until they're soft. Next up, we're gonna add the sunflower seeds. So we've got 1 cup of them going into a small saucepan. And then we're just gonna cover that with water and just boil that for about 5 minutes just to soften it up. Now, if you don't have a Vitamix, you may wanna do it for 7 to 10 minutes. Now it's time to chop up our onion. And again, you don't have to be too pedantic about how fine you chop it because it's all gonna go in the blender. Now time to chop the 2 cloves of garlic. Now don't forget to check on the sesame seeds and mashed potato. You can turn them off at this time and drain both. Now let's mash up that potato and put it into the 1/2 cup measure. Okay, now it's time to get that onion and garlic sizzling away. You'll be cooking that off for about 3 to 4 minutes, sauteing lightly, and just add a little bit of water in there just to get things going. Okay, after you've thoroughly rinsed and drained the sunflower seeds, you can add them to the pan with the onion and garlic. Then we'll be adding in 1/4 teaspoon of sesame seed oil. Give it a good stir to mix it all together and then let it saute for 2 to 3 minutes just until the seeds start to brown. Okay, now for the home stretch. Add your onion sunflower mix to the blender. Then we add the 1/2 cup of mashed potato, 1 teaspoon of vegetable stock, 1 teaspoon of apple cider vinegar, and 2 tablespoons of nutritional yeast. You may add a bit later, but we'll start with 2 for now. And then 1/8 teaspoon of a nutmeg. 1/4 teaspoon of mustard powder. And then 1 1/2 cups of water. And then blend that baby. Blend, blend, blend. Until you have it nice, smooth and creamy. Now I checked it about halfway through, gave it a mix and then blended a little bit further. And then I added in some more nutritional yeast, about another tablespoon, and then a good sprinkling of salt and pepper. And then blended that baby. And then the end result, smooth, creamy, vegan cheese. Now, this can be used as a dip. You can make it as like a macaroni and cheese. You could use it as a nice sauce over a baked sweet potato. Or you could do what I actually used it for and use it as like a base white creamy cheese sauce in a vegan lasagna. Oh yeah, the possibilities are endless. Well, that's all for now. If you would like to see what other vegan gluten-free recipes I have in store, please subscribe. And until next time, remember to live life by your definition. This is Justine from Gluten-Free Aussie Vegan, signing out.